Welcome back to Fox Recaps. Today, I'm going to explain the movie, Fists of Legend, released in the year 2013. Fists of Legend is a televised mixed martial arts tournament that invites former legendary street fighters to their show. They stir up old high school rivalry between middle-aged men and let them fight each other. The men mostly accept the offer for the prize money of $20,000. For the first round, they go against a professional fighter and have to survive in the ring for at least 2 minutes to win. Then, they fight against their old nemesis for the prize money. The program is gradually rising in popularity because of the interesting backstories of the fighters. At the beginning of the movie, a young man fights 14 men alone and beats them up with little to no effort. The stories of his bravery spread around and he gains popularity as One Man. However, that was 23 years ago. Currently, the One Man is in his 40s and owns a fried chicken restaurant. He is struggling financially and hence has to come to the Fists of Legend show to hopefully earn some money. For the first round, he goes against a professional fighter. The man is so out of shape that he cannot even land a single punch at the fighter. The former One Man is beaten up in no time and sent home without any prize money. The second contestant took down an entire group of gangsters when he was young. He is better than One Man, however, he doesn't last for 2 minutes against the professional fighter and is knocked out with a punch to his face. The third contestant is the most talented out of them all. He holds up pretty well for 1.5 minutes, but is trapped in a chokehold for the last 30 seconds. The viewers hold their breath waiting for him to tap out, but he stays still until the 2 minutes are over and is promoted to the second round. Then he goes against a nemesis and finally wins the prize money after an intense match. In the next scene, we're introduced to the protagonist of the film, Lim Deok-kyu, a 43-year-old man who owns a noodle restaurant. In high school, he used to be a boxer, aiming to win the Olympics. However, he had to give up his dream because of some problems. Since he also used to be a street fighter, the director of Fist of Legend, Gyu Min, is trying to recruit him. She comes to his restaurant as a customer and slyly brings up the topic of their show. Deok-kyu isn't interested in fighting, but the prize money piques his interest. Following the encounter, he goes to his in-law's house. Deok-kyu's wife died a few years ago, leaving him and his teenage daughter, Soo Bin, to themselves. Since then, Soo Bin has lived with her grandmother, who helps Deok-kyu around the restaurant sometimes. Deok-kyu notices that Soo Bin is sad about something. The next morning, he's called to a hospital by her teacher. It turns out that Soo Bin stabbed a classmate with a pencil. Deok-kyu kneels in front of the teacher to ask for forgiveness and promises to pay the hospital bill. Then, he tells Soo Bin he also used to be a bully in high school and playfully explains to her that slapping or punching is better than stabbing people. Deok-kyu's business is not doing well nowadays. He needs money for the hospital bill, so he decides to join the Fists of Legend. Somewhere else, director Gyu Min calls Deok-kyu's old friend and fellow street fighter, Song Hoon. She wants to bring him to the show to fight Deok-kyu, but he declines the offer. Song Hoon works as a manager for a big corporation that is run by his former high school friend, Jin Ho. Jin Ho is wealthy and mean and treats him like a toy. Throughout the years, Song Hoon has lost self-respect and thinks that he's living as Jin Ho's henchman. It seems unfair to him because Jin Ho got his wealth from his father and didn't have to work hard for it. That day, Jin Ho beats up a woman and disrespects the waiters as usual. Song Hoon has to clean up the mess for him yet again. The following day, Deok-kyu comes to the Fists of Legend studio to participate in a match. Since he used to be a talented, trained boxer back in the day, he's better than most of the middle-aged fighters who come to the show. In the first few seconds, he gets hit with a lower kick that makes him retreat. When his opponent starts to underestimate him, he throws several punches and knocks him out with an uppercut. The audience, along with the producers, are left speechless that a normal man could defeat a trained professional. For the next and final round, he's made to go against his associate from high school, Jae Seok. Since the producers couldn't convince Jin Ho to join the contest, they settled for another one of Deok-kyu's friends, Jae Seok. They go against each other in a friendly but intense match. In the end, the victory falls on Deok-kyu's side, and he wins the $20,000 prize money. After the match, Gyu-min wants to feature him in other matches as well, but Deok-kyu says that he doesn't need more money. He and Jae-seok talk about their high school life and decide to meet someday for coffee before going their separate ways. A flashback shows us the time Deok-kyu was in high school. His only wish in life was to represent South Korea in the Olympics. He practiced for hours every day to achieve his dream. One day on his way back home, he saw boys from a rival school beating up his juniors. One of the bullies was Jae-seok. It was the first time the two had met. Deok-kyu defeated them all and rescued his people. The following day at school, the word went around and Sang-hoon and Jin-ho found out about him. They approached Deok-kyu and the three started to hang out together. Jae-seok was still mad about being defeated, so he came to the school to teach Deok-kyu a lesson. But Sang-hoon fought him and sent him away. One day, Deok-kyu, Sang-hoon, and Jin-ho were hanging out in a park when Jin-ho asked the other two to fight for $200. Jin-ho was a spoiled rich kid who thought money was everything. His father's influence helped him get away with anything in life. As they talked, Jae-seok approached them yet again and challenged Deok-kyu to a duel. Deok-kyu let him punch him twice and invited him to the group. That is how the group of four was formed. Starting that day, they became inseparable and ruled their respective schools. Jin-ho grew up to inherit his father's business, while Sang-hoon remained his mere manager who cleans up after him. Soon, the Fists of Legend episode airs on television, and Deok-kyu's popularity skyrockets. His restaurant that once used to be empty now has a line of customers waiting outside. Deok-kyu doesn't plan to return to the show, but his mother-in-law forces him to go to maintain the restaurant's popularity. In the next match, Deok-kyu knocks out his opponent yet again. This time, he impresses the viewers with his sportsmanship when he picks up the opponent and asks him if he is all right after the match. That evening, he buys Soo-bin a tablet so she can draw on it. She is very good at drawing, hence Deok-kyu wants to support her dream to become an artist. They're in a restaurant when a group of boys from Soo-bin's school recognize Deok-kyu. On seeing them, Soo-bin grows nervous and doesn't look away from her tablet. For the next few weeks, Deok-kyu continues being a guest at the show and remains undefeated. The show's popularity skyrockets because of him. Even his former friends Sang-hoon and Jae-seok watch the matches, cheering for him. One night, Deok-kyu goes to a high school reunion and is welcomed by the juniors of his school. They praise him for his success and welcome him to the reunion. Deok-kyu is the center of the conversation. He even offers to pay for everyone's meal. However, the direction of the conversation changes when one of the juniors accuses him of bullying and making their lives difficult when they were just kids. He still hasn't forgotten how Deok-kyu and his group used to bully and threaten them. Deok-kyu realizes he was an awful person back then. A flashback shows us the time he found Sang-hoon bullying the weak for the first time. Deok-kyu retaliated because he didn't like the fact that they stole from the people who couldn't defend themselves. He insults Sang-hoon and calls him a leech who lives off Jin-ho's money. The following morning, they forget their differences and talk again. Sang-hoon reveals that he doesn't like using Jin-ho's money. He's only friends with Jin-ho because his father is their family's driver, so he feels indebted to them. Deok-kyu understands Sang-hoon a lot better after the conversation. Then comes the selection day for the 1988 Summer Olympics. The group cheers for Deok-kyu as he fights his opponent efficiently and knocks him out. However, the result is announced in the opponent's favor. Even the supporters of the opponent are surprised by the unfair results. When the coach retaliates, he is told that Deok-kyu doesn't have the family background to go represent Korea in the Olympics. Deok-kyu is heartbroken after the incident. Seeing his only dream in life getting away from him, he starts to drink and bully people. This is when he bullies the man who calls him out during the reunion. The group gets into fights with gangsters. They eventually turn into violent teenagers who don't care about anyone but themselves. In one of such fights, the police catch them and throw them in prison. Back in the present, director Gyu Min hasn't stopped trying to convince Song Hoon to come to their show to fight Deok Kyu. Since the show's producer is Jin Ho's friend, he uses his authority to make Song Hoon do as he says. He even goes as far as to claim that Song Hoon might be humiliated in the show, but if it helps his company, then it's worth it. Song Hoon has no choice but to accept the offer. The following day, Deok Kyu is in the restaurant when his daughter comes in after being beaten up by the bullies. When asked who did that to her, she doesn't say anything. Later, one of her classmates approaches Deok Kyu and tells him that she knows who the culprit is. She takes him to a secluded area when a bunch of kids from Soo Bin's school have gathered. The girl turns out to be one of the bullies who had taken the task of bringing him to the rest of the group. The boys want to fight Deok Kyu and want to get famous by doing so. Deok Kyu isn't interested in fighting kids, but then they reveal that Soo Bin never hit anyone. She is a shy and timid girl who is blamed for everything that the other kids do wrong. Deok Kyu realizes that all this time when he boasted about being a bully, someone else was doing the same to his daughter. In a fit of rage, he fights the kids when they attack him and defeats them with little to no effort. On returning home, Deok Kyu apologizes to his daughter for not being able to protect her, and the two reconcile. The next day is his match against Song Hoon. The directors are excited because it is one of the most important matches that has ever happened in the show. As soon as the match starts, it's evident that Deok Kyu is not in his best form. He misses most of his attacks and is knocked out at last. Song Hoon wins, but knowing Deok Kyu, he knows that he lost deliberately. When Song Hoon returns to the office, he is welcomed by a round of applause. Jin Ho is impressed by his win, but he has also realized that Deok Kyu lost only because he wanted to. He claims that he is dying to see if Song Hoon can still fight like he used to if given a tougher competition. Then he calls in three men to make them fight Song Hoon. For the first time in years, Song Hoon retaliates and asks Jin Ho to grow up. When threatened to be fired, he claims that he's quitting and storms off. Now, with no source of income, Song Hoon is worried about his family. He calls his son and asks him to choose any college he wants, boasting that he can pay any amount of tuition. Somewhere else, in the Fists of Legend headquarters, Gyu Min suggests an idea to increase the ratings of the show. She proposes they organize an 8-player knockout tournament, where the audience can vote for the players they want to see compete. The idea is brought to life as the Match of Legends Tournament and is advertised heavily. For the tournament, they plan to train the 8 fighters. The viewers love the idea and the show becomes a hit even before being released. At first, Deok Kyu doesn't want to get involved in the tournament, but when Soo Bin requests him to not give up on his dream, he agrees to take part. He goes to the training center where Song Hoon is also training alongside him. The friends reunite and decide to meet for coffee after the tournament. Even though they're meeting after years, their relationship hasn't changed much. A flashback shows us the time when the group of four were in a cell for starting a fight. Because of Jin Ho's father's influence, he was given a bail as soon as they were sent in. The rest were approached by a policeman who offered them a new way to make money. Oblivious to his true intentions, they followed him outside. A gangster named An seats them inside his car and takes them to a building. He then asks them to stab a guy 3 times and return to the car. If they do as told, they'll be taken into the gang and given money. The teenagers believe him and make their way into the building. Song Hoon and Deok Kyu say that this is wrong and want to retreat, but Jae Seok goes inside and kills the man. The other two see the car missing and realize that they were set up. Song Hoon runs away while Deok Kyu goes to help Jae Seok. However, in the end, he also has to run to not get caught and Jae Seok is arrested. He spends time in prison while the other guys live their life normally. Back in the present, Jae Seok comes to visit Deok Kyu in the middle of the night and brings him to a restaurant. There, he's introduced to the gangster An yet again. It turns out that after coming out of prison, Jae Seok started to work for the same person who was the reason for his imprisonment in the first place. and now owns a betting website and wants Deok-Q to lose in the semifinals for $200,000. It turns out that Jae Seok is also taking part in the tournament and has already agreed to lose for An. Deok-Q thinks about it for a while and takes the money. Outside, Jae Seok claims that he's disappointed in Deok-Q for accepting the deal, although he also did the same. On the day of the tournament, the auditorium is jam-packed with a crowd of people excited for the matches. An is among the people watching from the sidelines. In the back room, the fighters are getting ready. Soobin visits Deok-Q and wishes him luck. Deok-Q also introduces Sung-hoon and Jae Seok to her as her uncles. The matches finally start, and the three friends do their best. The show's ratings go higher and higher with each fight. Everything goes well until it is Jae Seok's turn to fight Turtle, the man who An paid to win. Even though Jae Seok had promised to tap out the first chance he gets, he doesn't do so. Instead, he fights the guy with all his might, surprising even the audience. For the second round, he doesn't attack and runs around the cage dodging his opponent. He does this so Turtle would get exhausted and it would be easier to win in the third round. However, the guy still manages to trap Jae Seok in a chokehold, making him tap out. Even though he lost, Jae Seok is ecstatic that he did his best. Following that, Sung-hoon wins several matches and reaches the semi-final. After an intense match, he wins and makes it to the finals. However, his leg is hurt in the process. The commentator asks him if he can go on, and he affirms. But when he steps out of the cage, he falls to the ground in pain. The paramedics are called and his leg is bandaged, but he is still adamant about playing in the finals. Following that, Deok-Q goes against Turtle in the semifinals. An smiles from the sidelines, thinking that he already knows the result. The match starts and the ratings instantly go higher. In the beginning, Turtle gets the upper hand and traps Deok-Q in a chokehold. But Deok-Q fights back with all his might and frees himself. Turtle yet again holds him in an armbar, but has to stop when the first round is over. In the second round, Deok-Q is visibly in better form. He manages to land some punches, but is yet again trapped in a guillotine choke. To everyone's surprise, he frees himself for a second time. In the final round, Deok-Q takes the upper hand and punches him several times. He even gives his opponent a chance to fight back, but sends him flying with every blow. Jae Seok approaches An and gives him the envelope of money that he had bribed Deok-Q with. In the end, Deok-Q wins the match with a blow to his neck. The crowd erupts in cheers and the host asks him how he feels. To everyone's surprise, he claims that he doesn't want to fight anymore and walks away. Gyumin follows behind him and asks him to get back to the cage because the live show cannot end. Sung-hoon claims that if Deok-Q withdraws, he will get the prize money. Gyumin likes the idea because she can broadcast it as one friend chooses money while the other friend chooses friendship. Sung-hoon promises to share the money in half with Deok-Q. In the last scene, we see Deok-Q and Soo-bin walk outside the arena. Soo-bin is proud of her father for being so brave. Because of him, she decides to return to her old school instead of getting transferred. That was all from the video. I hope you liked it. Subscribe for more content like this and hit the like button to help us out. Also, leave a comment if you want us to recap your favorite movie. Until next time, take care.